Welcome to We Are Finn, and with me right now I have Stephen Phipson, CBE, the head of DSO within DIT. Welcome to We Are Finn, Farnborough International News Network. Of course, your main role is supporting UK exports. How's that looking at the moment? What's the market like?
Well, good. So we support three different areas of exports. We support the defence exports from the UK. That's the D part of DSO. Security exports are the other part, and that falls into two different areas, which is protective security, so border security applications, what we're doing with counter-terrorism, and of course what we're doing on cyber protection as well, so the government-to-government cyber program. So an exciting time. All three areas are doing very, very well at the moment. Defence we'll talk about in more detail, but just a quick word on the other two. Cyber has been growing at about 15% a year for us at the moment, and it's reaching about £2 billion a year of exports from the UK, so lots of innovation, lots of small companies involved in that program, and lots of governments really trying to learn from the experience of the UK over the last 5 years, so we're doing very well with that. And on the security part, I would say there's a rise in border protection programs around the world. People thinking about the migration issues they're seeing at the moment, about the uncertainty and tensions around the world, and how they actually build up more sophisticated border protection regimes than they've had previously.
And what are the priority markets that you're looking at?
Well, we define 36. If you look at the website, we have 36 core markets that the government concentrates on, primarily for defence exports and also the security export brief. And of those, they fall into, you know, large buckets. So the Middle East, of course, continues to be a very strong partner for defence and security exports for the UK. And also Southeast Asia, if we look at that. The other area that's coming up quite quickly for us is South America, where we're seeing interesting requirements that we think the UK has a lot of expertise that can be offered to places like Brazil, Chile, Colombia. So we are spending an increasing amount of our time in those areas as well.
And is that reflected in the trends that are taking place?
Yeah, it is a little bit. I would say that one of the interesting trends we're seeing is the rise of indigenous manufacturing. So countries that have been traditionally export customers for us in terms of products or services are now really thinking about building up their own indigenous capability. And I would cite, for example, the new indigenous fighter programs that we're seeing in Turkey, in Japan, in South Korea, a little bit in the UAE, where they're trying to build their own requirements. And we have a big part to play in that. This is also a very good opportunity for our smaller companies as well in the supply chain, because it's not just about the big primes selling a Typhoon, it's about the supply chain of all that important technology going into that local market that's important in those requirements.